God's love and peace bring all comfort during this time of grief, and may her soul rest in peace. And we offer now 1. All COVID-19 protocols are in effect, just to remind you. Once on the church compound, masks must be worn at all times, covering both your nose and your mouth. Hands must be sanitized on entry into the building. Social distancing must be as safe as possible. Well, try to. Entrance to the building will be from the main door at the front of the church only, right? And exit through either side or the other doors. Once you exit the building, for any reason, you are to re-enter through the main door at the front and re-sanitize. The washrooms are located to the back of the church, and the walk paths around the church will lead you to these. If any assistance is needed, please keep listening at the front desk. Thank you. Please turn off all cell phones. At this time, we invite the person delivering the eulogy. Please do so.
Get
call the parlor tidy, so pretty dogs do exactly fishes. You are the epitome of the wife, and I emulate you. Uncle Russell could not have asked a better match. A better wife. She served him faithfully for 36 plus years. A woman like that is rare. There isn't anyone that could ever replace Randy. But I know your husband is grieving, lost, empty, but trying to be strong to pay them talents. I promise to always be there for them in every way possible, but this transition of not having them, they may never fully go into. But let me take that his point. Tom, when it comes to rainy, that is a whole other level. Patty was just ridiculous with rain. She was the child, and Ray was the aunt. But not a Ray could say Auntie Patty, not even Miss Patty. She called her Patty from the time she started off, and Auntie was okay with that. The soft spot Patty had for Ray made things bad for me, because now I was the stepmother, as Ray tells me I am, and Patty is the nice mother. When I send Ray my Patty on a Friday for the weekend, and Ray come back on Sunday, all the handwriting in rainbow is tatty. All the coloring is tatty. Ask Rain, why ain't we a roof? Well, I started it and the statue wanted to do it for me. Why was coloring and Patty take my pencil? When I called Aunt Patty out the washing, Rain was tired of the washing, she knew. But something about you got a extra special. Your older sisters, Arlene and Jacqueline, and baby brother and sister, will forever miss, love and cherish you. You all grew up close, and even though migrated to different parts of the world, you all kept a close relationship. You Patty remained in Trinidad, although traveled frequently because your life and heart was here with us. You are a gem, and 54 years of having you was not enough. Miss Patty, as all your students called you, you was an amazing teacher. Teaching at Nestor Patrick Mission School for 27 years. Nearly everyone in Torchwood, Paparo, London Mill, even as far as South Paro, passed through your hands. You were the foundation of education in the community that gave children the amazing start and bright futures they have today. For you to miss a day of school, which is never, flood and storm had to prevent you. I don't know what Mr. Patrick would be like in September, but I know Miss Lana and all his school will ever be seen. All your kids will forever miss you, Auntie. I can have you all sitting here for years with nothing but amazing stories of Patty. Marlene, Margaret, Patty, Kanhai, Cabie, you are the best. You are the angel, and for that you will forever be in our hearts. Your love was cut short, but I know you lived it fulfillingly. I wrote you a letter, Auntie, so when you reach up in heaven and is sitting on your throne, which I know won't be long, because you will get up and look for a room to sleep or wash and pull clothes. But when you settle, please read my letter, for there are many things I have to tell you, and we spoke about, and then picked up chance. Please watch, guide, and protect, hold on us forever and always. Yes, sir.
You never said goodbye. You never said I'm leaving. You never said goodbye. You were born before I knew it. I'm only born in your life. A million times I needed you. A million times I cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life, I love you dearly. In death, I love you still. In my heart, you hold a place that no one could ever fill. It broke my heart to lose you, but you didn't go alone. For part of me went with you. The day God took you home. Sleep in peace and clarify our gardening haircut.
Thank you. He comforts us in all our afflictions, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him.
I bless the body of Christ with the holy water that falls to mind of baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into His death. By baptism into His death, we were buried together with Him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with Him by likeness to His death, so shall we be united with Him by likeness to His resurrection. On the day of the baptism, Marlene put on Christ, and the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed with glory.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom, chapter 3, verse 9, 1 to 9. The souls of the believers are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. Their leaving us like annihilation. But they are at peace. If they experience punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great will their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like a golden furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out. As sparks run through stable, so will they. They shall judge nations, rule over peoples, and the Lord will be their king forever. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those that he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
Our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes the Savior we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ.
That is the pain that we go through in life.
death. It causes more ailment. It causes more diseases. And we lose our faith, our compassion, our trust in God. But the Lord says to us in today's gospel, see that you are dressed for action and have your lamps lit. What is the action that we are called to be ready for? What is that action? That action is something that we need to do in our lives, which is love, which is care, which is concern, which is for unity and community and family. Do we love in our lives? Because God is love. And God has called us to love. What is so difficult about loving, about caring? What is so difficult about compassion and understanding? But we want to go to heaven when we die. We want to see the face of God and live in the kingdom of heaven forever. But we do not want to do what God has called us to. So he says, see that you are dressed for action. See that you can love. See that you can care. See that you can be compassionate and understanding. See that you can have a change of heart and a change of mind in the things that you do and the way you live. And I've just a beautiful word about our sister and the hurt and the pain of leaving. But can we add that to our way of life? Can we add that to the commands that God has given to us and He expects of us? Can we be a forgiving people? A loving people, a caring people. A people who can heal the hurts and the pain and the anger. You know, some people die without anger they have had. Especially to their old family members. Because the lack of care and concern that we have for one another. But we need to be ready each day of our lives, for life and for death. We need to care and we need to be concerned and we need to live in hope. We need to live in the love of God and the care of humanity and the joy that He brings to our life. And we live our life to the fullest with peace and love and care and concern for one another and for ourselves. It reflects the greatest commandment that Jesus has told us. Love God with all your heart, your mind, your soul, your strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. What he said to us is that we need to love God with everything we have. And in loving God, we need to love our neighbor. For he says, I believe each and every one of you, when you do this to the least of my brothers, that you do unto me. You love your neighbor. And you, the last person you love, is yourself. And you, the first person you love, is yourself. Because you have to share that love of God and the love of life that He's given to you. And that is a battle that is before us today. And we stand before God on Judgment Day. Once we are born, we must die. And we have to remember that. And once we die, there is judgment. And when is this judgment, when this judgment takes place, it's either heaven or hell. We can say what we want. But it's that judgment that is appearing in our life. And we live that judgment here on earth. For if we are ready to receive God here on earth, he says to us, well done, good and faithful servant. And if we are not, he said, I don't know you. And none of us would like to hear the words from Jesus, I don't know you. But we have to live that life. We have to live that life. We have to live that creed. Because once we love, God. We stand up, we love God, we sing the praises of God, we enjoy the presence of God. But we have to love one another. It reminds us of the cross that we carry, the pain that we will carry in loving people. It's a sad thing to say, it goes through pain. But we must go through that pain with love in our heart. So that is the preparation for the love of God in the kingdom. So we cannot say to God, if we have to enter the kingdom, we say, who is this person doing here? What is this person doing here? Why is this person here? So if we cannot say that to God while we are in heaven, we better not say it here. While we are there. Because the life we live here echoes the life in the kingdom of heaven. Today, we give thanks to God for our sister, for the life she lived. For the love she has had. We give thanks to God. And we pray this day that her soul will be taken up to God. Where she will be with the saints, the apostles, and all those who have died in the presence of God and have loved God. And we pray that they too will be waiting and who will overcome to receive God in his kingdom. May her soul find rest in God. May she find that grace and peace. Will be in the arms of God. Give on the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us all stand as we have our general intercession and pray for the soul of the Lord and the Lord. And especially for Marlene. God, the Almighty Father, raise Christ the Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save his people, both living and dead. And our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For Marlene, who in baptism was given the pleasure of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For deceased relatives and friends, and all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their eternal goodness in the land of the living, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Marlene, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend, Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer our prayers to the Father. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And we pick up our love offering.
Oh,
go ahead.
Go ahead.
Thank you.
please stand. Trusted in God, we have prayed together for Marlene, and now we come to the last day of life. There is sadness and parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Marlene again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will express in sorrow the mercy of God, to gather us together again in the joy of His kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another with the faith of Jesus Christ.
Grant that our sister may sleep in peace
until you awaken her to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God. For you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Because God has chosen to follow Sister Marlene from this life to himself, we commit our body to thee. For we are dust, and of dust we shall return. And I will reign. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his resurrection, the tomb you have the grace of all you believe in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayer. For those who have died in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever with joy in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Each of them rest grant us well, O Lord.
And let your blessed light shine upon us.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May your soul and souls of all faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of the Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
God save the Lord.
And as we take our sisters by the honor of the church, which rest in place, we say, may the angels lead you to paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And where Lazarus is born alone, but may you find eternal rest. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
And may your soul and the souls of all the faithful departed for the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.